Guy Joseph is adamant that based on the government's behavior, he does not see evidence that it cannot pay the civil servants the pay hike they are demanding. The former minister referred to what he described as extensive travel by government ministers and says it appears that the Labour administration wants only the people to tighten their belts. He made specific reference to what he said was the extravagant launching of jazz last week to support his argument.
I'm not saying that it's not necessary. I'm saying that if you are calling for austerity and you are saying to me, as an average Saint Lucian, I need to cut back on my expenses, what are you doing as a government? When you look at all the high-paying jobs that this government has created, the way that they have padded up the public service with other persons, we operated at a level where I'm seeing where we had one permanent secretary, they have two, sometimes three. What signal are you sending?
Mr. Joseph also referred to the government's introduction of value-added tax, which did not exist under the former United Workers' Party administration. He says VAT has caused inflation and reduced the value of disposable income.
We subsidize rice, flour, sugar, fuel, cooking gas, all of these things we dealt with without the VAT, and we were able to pay. So for the government to say, I am unable to pay, even with VAT, I think that the government owes the people of the country a better explanation than what they are giving. I cannot buy into the fact that you are just saying, this cannot be so or this can be so. What are the facts?
According to the former minister, the public service has been padded using capital projects rather than the normal way of providing employment. He wanted to know how many of the programs under capital expenditure will actually be used to pay salaries. Mr. Joseph says civil servants showed during the time that the UWP was in power, they were very capable negotiators. And now that the Labour is in government, he hopes they display the same capability. For the DBS News World, Alex Puske reporting.